Hello, boys and girls of YouTube land. This is gonna be, for me, what feels like one of my stranger video responses. You see, it started with a YouTuber by the name of 11 the One. And he dropped a comment on one of my videos. And in that comment, he says, "Now," he then dropped me a PM. "Check out these vids about the UN vehicles." And I did that.
"Take a real close look. This is very interesting. Again, you'll notice the Air Force base is hidden with the trees and things like that, so a lot of people can't see, but this is one of the main airstrips here. You have airstrips going this way and this way, and this one here. But if you zoom in really close, you can see there's a bunch of things sitting on those airstrips. I don't know if you can make that out on here or not, but if you do, or if you can look, and go in here. Here's the beginning of the airstrip. Let's just go in as close as we can get on this. This is UN vehicles. Intel Hub. Thousands of UN vehicles are possibly staging at Reynolds Air Park in Green Cove, Florida. By the way, if y'all will go in and check out the air park, you'll find out that it has been used with the CIA. I mean, there's all kinds of stuff you can look. If you guys will just do the research, don't take my word for anything.
And I'm back. Alright. Now, 11 the One. First of all, it doesn't take a genius to figure that we could see World War III sometime within the next 25 to 50 years. Why? Because we're slaughtering animals. There has never been a time throughout human history, throughout any generation, that there was not. So as far as Bible predictions goes, that's what we would call a self-fulfilling prophecy. You'd grab that from the past. As far as the UN vehicles go there, and? Yeah, it's a preparation for something big. It's being prepared. And as far as the rabbi names Jesus, is this really the best you got? First, you got to verify that this is actually true. Not what he did. I've got no problem believing this guy felt he had visions. He was also 108 years old, according to this article. Now, I understand that you and religious folk like you, you're really just trying to look out for your fellow people. Sure. But I want to tell you this right now. Even if God, according to the Bible, was real, I would rather be smashed into oblivion than to be spending eternity kissing the ass of a bipolar deity. He's a hypocrite. According to the Bible, he's a hypocrite. He's fast to anger. No, he's slow to anger. He never forgives. He forgives. You see where I'm going with this? I would not want to spend all eternity kissing his ass. I'd rather be smashed into oblivion, being no more. You cannot save my soul if I had one. I will. I'd rather. To me, torture for eternity would be kissing his ass. I mean, it says Jesus was the perfect Son of Man. He was the perfect person, the perfect man without sin. But anger's a sin. And didn't he get angry in the church? Go ahead, justify that. It doesn't matter if you can justify it. He got angry. Therefore, if anger is a sin, then he sinned. It's that simple. Like I said, bipolar God. Eternal punishment would be kissing his ass forever. I'm going to leave it with that. I don't believe there's a God. What you have here, at best, is circumstantial. But I appreciate you trying. Alright? Somehow magic. I'll catch you later.